Today, let us do exercise 3C, solving the following system of linear equation, either by substitution method or elimination method. We are trying to find the values of x and y for the given equation. Let us start with the question number 3. Here we have 0.4x plus 0.3y. equal 1.7 as the first equation, 0.7x minus 0.2y equal 0.8. We have to get value of x and y. Let us do it by elimination method. How to do? We'll see this way. We will try to make the coefficient of x or y equal. Either you make the coefficient of x equal or the coefficient of y equal. So how to do that? We have to multiply by such number so that they will be equal. I want to make the coefficient of x equal here. We have decimal. So let us multiply by number. Forget about the decimal. Here we have 4. Here we have 7. 4 into what will be 7? We don't have. 7 into what will be 4? We don't have. So we just cross to multiply. Coefficient of x from equation 2, we multiply equation 1. Then coefficient of x from 1, we multiply question 2. Let's forget about decimal, we'll take only the number. So here for equation 1, I will multiply with 7. Then equation 2, I'll multiply by coefficient of x from equation 1, that is by 4, okay? Roughly, you can write it like that, 7 and 4. From where I get this 7, coefficient of x from equation 2. From where I get this 4, coefficient of x from equation 1. So that will have no problem for decimal. Let it be there, we'll just multiply by number. So now 7 into 4 will have 2.8 because one number after decimal. 7 into 3, 2.1, one number after decimal. 7 into 17, we have 11.9 because one number after decimal. Then 4 into 7, 2.8, x will remain, minus remain the same. 7, 4 into 2, we have 0.8, one number after decimal. 4 into 8, we have 32, one number after decimal. Then now we have both sign are plus, so let's subtract it in order to change the sign. So we multiply with minus, so minus to minus become plus to plus become minus. So now 2.8 become 0, so we eliminate x. Here we have both are plus, so we plus 2.1, 0.8, we get 2.9y. Here plus, here minus, so we minus 9 minus 2, 7, point is there, decimal, 11, 3, 8. We want y, so 89 divided by 2.9, that will give us value of y. So in order to calculate the value, let us remove the decimal. Here we have one number after decimal, there also we have one. So we put 10 up, 10 down, okay? When we have decimal down, we put 0 up. When we have 0 up, we put decimal down. So 0, 0 cancel. 87 divided by 29, we get it 3. Now we get y equal to 3. We can replace it in equation 1 or equation 2 to get the value for x. So let us replace it in equation 1. So everything will remain same. Only in place of y, we will put with 3, okay? 0.4x will remain, 1.7 will remain. So here, only in place of y, we put with 3. So 3 into 3 will be 9. This is plus, take that side, become minus. We have only one number after decimal, so it will be there. 17 minus 9 will be 0.8. Then we want x, so 0.8 divided by 0.4. Let's get rid of decimal. Here we have one number after decimal, put 10 up. Here we have one number after decimal up, we put 10 down. So we divide it, we get x equal to 2, y equal to 3. If we check here, answer correct or not. 4 into 2, 0.8, 3 into 3, 0.9. So 0.8, 0.9, we get 1.7. That means the answer is correct. 7 into 2 will be 1.4. 3 into 2 will be 0.6. 1.4 minus 1.6, we get 0.8. So if left equal to right, that means the answer is correct. Then we will go on to number 2. Here also you can do the same. Here I will do with another method known as substitution. So let me start from equation 1. We need to separate x and y. So we leave y here. X is plus. If I take the side, become minus. So better to leave only y here. 0.5 number with x. So here in 2, we can bring down, become divide. So we name this as equation 3. We start from equation 1. Now we have to replace it in equation 2. How to replace? Not everything. Only in place of y, we will put with this value. Okay? So 0.5x, let it be, plus 0.7, let it be. Now, in place of y, we'll not write y anymore. We will write with this value, okay? 0.5 minus 0.3x by 0.5, then this side still equals 0.74. Then now, this one leave it as it is. Here we multiply 7 into 3, 35. We have one number after decimal here, one here. So ultimately it will be 2. Then 7 into 3, 21. Here also, one here, one here. Ultimately be 2. Then 0.5, let it remain down. We have fraction, so we take LCM of 1 and 0.5. So definitely it will be 0.5. Here also we have 1. So in order to remove the denominator, we can multiply each side by, each part by, the LCM, that is 0.5. So after we do so, divide the LCM by the numerator and multiply with numerator, we will get here two number after decimal, okay? Then there, here. So this one now we can cross multiply that side. Then this one x, so we can minus. Minus 2, 5, minus 2, 1 will be 0.04. Because we have two number after decimal, we cannot change that. Then we multiply this one and this one. We get how many number after decimal? 1, 2, 3. Okay? This is plus. Take the side, become minus. So we minus this one, we will get 0.02. We have to be careful with decimal. Okay? Then we want only x. So here in 2, you can divide. We can remove the decimal. We have 2 number after decimal. Put 2 zero up. We have 2 number after decimal up, we can put down. So we can sell, we get 1 by 2. That means if you divide 1 by 2, x will be 0.5. So that same one, we can replace it in equation 3, okay? To get the value for x. So, the value for y. So everywhere remains same, only in place of x, we put 0.5. So the rest remains same. Here, 3 into 5, 15. We have 2 number after decimal, we count it properly. Then here we have minus, so we minus this one and this one. When you minus, be careful, okay? It'll be 0.15, 0.5. So 5 will come down, then 11 minus 5. Okay, we'll get those. Then here we want only y, this, to divide, we remove the decimal. So one number after decimal, we can put 1 0 up. 2 number after decimal, you can put down. 1 0 can be cancelled. So 35 divided by 50, we get 0.7. So that means the value for x is 0.5. The value for y is 0.7. Here we have 0.5. Then because here we have 2 number after decimal, we can put with another 0 to make it complete. Okay, 0.15. Then we can borrow as usual. 10 minus 5, 5. 4 minus 3 will be, 1 will be 3. So that is how we get 0.35. The same way, this number 33, you can try yourself. You can do with any method, either multiply by elimination method or by substitution method.